We are going to see the qualities of a successful entrepreneur. That is, for an entrepreneur to be called successful or to be successful, what are the main qualities he or she should possess? That is, you can identify an entrepreneur different from a simple trader or a businessman. So what is there behind anybody's success who is an entrepreneur? So let us see the qualities of successful entrepreneur. We'll take examples, and also we will see that what that particular example shows, that person shows different qualities. So whatever you have is good. You need to make it more, say, emancipated, or you can just polish it. And if you don't have it, try to develop it. So here is just an exercise which has been given, that you have to tell that all the people who are doing business around you or working, what quality do you like about them or you see? So let me tell you one of the thing which is being said here. If you see your milkman, the person who supplies milk to you, he is very hardworking. Why hardworking? Because he wakes up at 3 a.m. and comes to the customer house 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, sometimes 6 o'clock. So people normally, if you go to the metropolitan, people sleep at this time. But he wakes up at this time. So that is how the commitment and hard work is there, right? So there is a very thin line, a very fine line. So if you say you are an entrepreneur, and if you say that you are a business person, there is a very fine, minute line between it, right? So let us see what is that fine line, because both are doing almost similar kind of work. They are making money. They are doing some new job, trading. But certain qualities distinguishes an entrepreneur from a normal, traditional, conventional kind of business person, right? So Ramu is a chaiwala. Chaiwala means he is a tea seller. He makes tea and then sell a nearby bus stop. And we know that in bus stop, we generally get so many people. So generally here, the influx of people are too much. Now he is making profit because he makes good tea, bus stop, profit. So he's kind of a traditional business person. He has been doing it. Everyone is doing it. You can see the chaiwala in nook and corner everywhere, right? Because what you do? Take milk, some tea, then water. You can add some, different thing like elaichi, etc., cardamom and these things also. But Rani, now I'm taking an example of the same thing done differently in an innovative way. In a way, it was not being addressed. So Rani started a tea stall. She also started a tea stall, but maybe she couldn't get a space near bus stop. She started it on the roadside. Now she decided to sell different kind of flavors here. That is not only the conventional tea, but she decided to sell different kind of flavors. For example, the cardamom tree, the ginger tea, ginger lemon tea. So if you go to a tea parlor in mall, in big malls, you'll see this happening. So she just opened on a roadside. Now the flavor she is providing is quite different in a reasonable price. That is, normally 10 rupees today is the cost of a conventional tea. She is just charging 20. But if you go to a parlor, big place, they may charge you 100, 200 like this. So people are coming here not because she's giving it for less, but because she has a unique idea. And everyone doesn't want to have a masala chai or a normal chai, normal tea. They want different kind of tea. Like today, everyone is after green tea. So the different kind of person, like politicians, delivery journalists, actors are coming. So someone will come, they want some different taste. Other will come, they want different taste. So she has a variety which is liked by everyone. She might be just having a dip, you know, dip kind of tea. That is called Lipton tea. Okay, so that is only Lipton tea, but the flavor she is providing, the flavor or different kind of taste she is offering is something unique. And it is different from the traditional chai wala. That is how Rani is an entrepreneur. She is an entrepreneur. Now let us take an example of a making of entrepreneur. Sushma, she is a woman, she is married, and she has two young kids. Sushma, she has two young kids to look after. And when she saw something, what will happen? Today, the wife will give, or the woman will give their kids mobile phone. They will see mobile phone and finally they will have all the problems. Or they will give them the plastic toys. That is, either the mobile phones or the plastic toys are given to play. But you know, both of them are not good for the body, for especially for the kids. These kids are really, you know, very, very sweet, very, very komal kind. And when you see that most of the problems, especially the specs, the eyes, they are, every kid you see are they are wearing the specs in early ages. So for the environment also it is bad. It is bad for the kids because plastic has certain chemicals which is very harmful. Now she got an idea, or she thought that I need to make certain thing like toys. First of all, you know, we need to get rid of these health problems, because all these gadgets are not making them think. That is, the brain is not being trained, or big brain exercise is not being done, and they are, in fact, it's creating health issues. So that is how this business idea has changed everything for Sushma. She thought, let me make toys which are made up of wood. Let me make wooden toys. Okay. So now the kids will learn also, and this wood is always healthy. So she started making these wooden toys, and with friends and family, she started sending the pictures, telling them that, okay, what she has started, what she wanted to do, and please buy it. So everyone was very excited, because she has done something very, very new, very different, very unique. Because no one has thought these plastic toys are easy to buy, and they are very, very cheap also. Now what happened? Sushma, she is having a very good friend, best friend actually. So the best friend told her in private that the toys I bought from you has sharp edges. So because of the sharp edges, my child got hurt. Because, you know, wood maybe, you know, if it's not made styled properly, it can create some part which can hurt people. So now Sushma changed the design. Soft edges she made. She changed the design as per the user requirement, as per the customer requirement, and she changed it. But people have already heard about that she has that hard edges or not very soft edges. So even she tried a lot. She tried to convince people, because she was aware of the qualities her product has. So she was saying, everyone, please buy it. I have changed it and it is very healthy, very good and cheap also for you and your kids. Now, if somebody like you and me is there, we would normally, you know, get disheartened and then we will just leave this world. But she didn't give up. Sushma didn't give up. She started thinking. Again, she started a business idea or thinking of the business idea. How these parents buy these toys? What is the buying pattern? What do they think? So she realized and she came to know that the toys are being bought normally from a permanent shop. Because people don't go here and there. They just go to a good shop and establish a shop. Because the permanent shop has all the variety for girls, boys, and they have soft toys. They have different kind of electronic toys, right? So she went to these shop owners and she asked for the partnership. She also created a website. Now, she was doing all these and she was very patient. She took 2 years. And after that, the demand of her toys increased exponentially. And not only in the area she was working, also because of the website, she was now selling these all over the world. Her toys, wooden toys, all over the world. Right? So, we saw and we discussed that if you are an entrepreneur or if you want to be an entrepreneur, there are certain qualities you should possess. First is patience. Patience, you have seen Sushma. She started making toy and she started making a wooden toy, but it had these sharp edges. So she changed the design as per the user requirement, made the soft toy with very, very stylish edges. Okay. Made it mostly round. And then she partnered with various shops, opened the website. And after 2 years of starting the work, she actually got success. So first thing is patience. Entrepreneurship or being an entrepreneur is just not a one-day job. You won't get success in one day. Okay, it will take some time to establish and you won't get everything quickly. So Sushma, you know, kept working for trying hard for 2 years. That's how she got success. Second thing is positivity. See, someone will say anything against you or bad about you, you will get disheartened. Because in every era, every society, there will be people who are going to give you some or the other, you know, critical kind of feedback. So difficulties and failures will always there. So you have to keep your mind, your heart as calm as possible, as positive as possible, because somebody said something against and you started thinking bad about you or disheartened. And then you have to take risk. Okay. Because even if you think positively, then only you will be able to take a risk. Right? Whenever you make food, some of the rice always remain. 2 or 3 rice will always remain in the pot. Okay. So you have to be very specific, very clear about your goal. Right? That is, if you want to earn, say, 50,000 or 1 lakh in a month, you have to stay positive. Sushma were very positive. She actually listened to the customer complaint. Actually, you know, she may get upset. Actually, the feedback person was her best friend only. She might have fought with her. What are you saying? I have good product. But she didn't fought with her. But actually, she made improvement in her product. Right? And this improvement led to the success. Now, there are certain more things which comes. First is hardworking, never give up, and perseverance. That is, perseverance means doing things again and again and not dying out of, inventiveness and working workaholism. So, you know, you will always get failure. There is no person who is not who will not fail. For example, you make a program, say C program. Whenever you write program, there will be a semicolon error, there will be a round error, there will be so lot of compilation error, and you know, these kind of error will come. So until you get success, just work hard. You see, Sushma kept trying again and again because she was failing at every juncture, every milestone. But she tried and she actually succeeded. And this is the hard work pays. Coming to confidence. See, when you are making a decision or you are talking to someone, or you are, see, even if you go to some job interview, you have to show your confidence. Because if you are not confident in your life, if you are not confident in your work, if you are not confident of the product you are making or the services you are providing, the other person, why he or she will buy it? See, if you are here and there is a customer and you are trying to tell him or her something, if you are not confident, you are not because it's all about your product. If your product is good, if your services are good, if you are really want to be a good entrepreneur, then you need to show confidence. The customer will get satisfied. Otherwise, he will just run away. So the product, if you have quality, your services, if it has quality, good quality, then what will happen? It will show your confidence. And if you do this confidence, work confidently, you will get success. Then coming to open to trial and error. So what happens? You know, everywhere you will see. Say for example, we are making chicken biryani, we are making veg biryani, or say dosa. Now all these things, this was not made in one day. It might have taken hundreds and hundreds of years to people do trial and error. And finally came up with the chicken biryani the way we are eating today. And people are still doing trial and error. Someone might be using some other spices. Some might be using some egg inside it. Some might be using some way of cooking differently. For example, dosa. You know, dosa, now it's, you name it and you have it. It's paneer dosa, it's egg dosa, it's chicken dosa. So these are all trial and error method people have done. And that is how things have come up. So as an entrepreneur, you need to be open to very new ideas, right? And you need to try them. You are saying, oh, this idea won't work. This idea will fail. Even if it fails, it will give you an experience, right? Don't lose your confidence. The trial and error experiment are very important because there are different ideas you can apply. Because unless you have a special idea, you are not an entrepreneur. You are a traditional businessman. Right? As I was saying about chicken biryani, see, all these ingredients, some masala, some spices someone has made. And once they have made, now they have a big chain of hotels all over India. For example, take example of Kareem in Delhi. Or wherever, you know, there are different names. But what they have done is now they have come to a point after doing all trial and error, failing multiple times. And now they have come up with a recipe that is well accepted. People run to buy it. People are crazy about that taste. But it has not come without this trial and error. Okay? See, Sushma, if she was not able to sell it to friend and family, she should have just sat on her own, sat inside her house and nothing. See, if she is selling it for 100 to the say shop, 200, the shop owner is selling 50, she is getting, even then she is getting profit. Okay? Creativity and innovation. See, being an entrepreneur means doing thing differently. Okay, not doing a different thing, doing the same thing differently. So you need to be very open to different perspectives, different ideas, different inputs, different feedbacks, and trying to use your idea and innovation. Everything has to be original and it has to be very creative. You cannot only go with what is already being done, right? See, if you do innovative solution or do something which is real and something which people want, the creativity will win. If you are a self-employed person and you don't have all these qualities, you are not an entrepreneur. You are only an entrepreneur when you have all the qualities which we discussed. Calculated risk you are going to take. You need to be very patient. You need to be very confident. You need to be hardworking. You need to be having all that kind of perseverance that is required. And all the innovative and creativity ideas, new ideas, you have to come up with. And there will be failures. There will be problems. You will get opportunity. You may get some chances, because life will give chances. Now coming to question and answer. Identify qualities of falling entrepreneur. Also write why you think this person has this quality or the qualities. First one. Anil wanted to do something very different and something no one has thought of before. He decided to start a special travel services for old people and senior citizens. Now Anil, see, everyone is having a taxi service now. Ola is there, Uber is there, Make My Trip is there, you know. Every kind of Ozo, Gozo, number of taxi services are there. But he did something differently. No one has thought about the senior citizen. And he started giving benefit to them. Because it's very difficult after 60. You know, you are a kid. You might be very well with your apps and, you know, paying and all these things. But about senior citizen. So if you see the qualities, he has done or he has thought something very different. And all these characteristics, actually, this is the answer of the next discussion. But you need to take risk, work hard, discipline, very flexible and adaptable to the environment. You need to do something for the market, and you need to have financial literacy and money management skill, and effective planning and execution is required. So if you see here, Anil actually thought of an idea, because taxi services are already there. But he came up with a novel idea of helping the old people, senior citizen. First thing is this. And he is an entrepreneur. Second is Rakesh loves playing outdoors. He used to spend his evenings with his friends playing games. But he had seen that many of his friends didn't like playing outdoors because they didn't feel safe. He decided to open a playground for children of all ages with proper security. He found an unused playground, got permission to use it, and asked his friend to help him clean it. He hired a security guard for the playground. He charged a small fee for people who wanted to play. So both parents and children liked this area and started playing there regularly. His business helped children who would not play outdoor before. So Rakesh, see, they don't want to play outside. They might be playing near road or wherever. But the thing is, it was unsafe. So there was a ground. He used his idea. He first secured it. It was unused, but he secured it. He changed it the way it can be used by people. And he hired some people. So he gave jobs. First is being an entrepreneur. He came up with a new idea. Then he started creating job. And now he was solving the problem of the society, solving the problem of the people. So people were actually requiring it, but no one was addressing it. Okay. So this unused area was being utilized. And then he started work with a very small remuneration. That is, he was taking very less money. But if the mouth publicity is there, he might get a lot of money. People would come because they are getting a secure environment. Radhika was a cook in a small restaurant in her area. She made enough money to support her husband and children. She decided to start her own food stall to sell Punjabi food. She would make a special parathas. A few days after starting her business, the police came and told her that she was not allowed to run her stall in the area. Radhika did not give up. She started tiffin service through which she would deliver fresh food to people. So first of all, Radhika was already working. She already had a job. So she could be a normal job working salary person. But she first took the risk. She came up with a new idea only for parathas. Because no one is there only making parathas. So she took a risk. She had a new idea. She dropped the job. She resigned from the job. So these all are the qualities of entrepreneur. Then when the police came, now everyone is scared of police, especially in our country. So she might have, got scared and she would leave everything and sit in their home. But the thing is, she was very patient. She didn't, she got disheartened. She was hardworking. She was all single-handedly doing all this. But she was hardworking. She didn't get dejected by the thought that the police is saying no to her stall. Okay? But she knew that she had that quality. The parathas are required. People are asking for the parathas, especially the Punjabi and nearby region. So she didn't go away off the track. She kept to the idea she started. And in order to get it work, she started the tiffin service. Do you think you have qualities of an entrepreneur in you? If yes, give examples when you showed it. So we have already discussed this. These are the answers you can use, but this is from the next discussion. But we'll be talking about this in the next discussion. So let me go back and show you that in order to be a good entrepreneur, you need to be patient, have patience, be positive, don't think negative. Failures will always be there. Difficulties will always come to you. You need to be hardworking, don't give up, and have this perseverance. Confidence is the key for anything, not only of being an entrepreneur. And always try trial and error method. Experiment with new ideas, new things, innovations. Creativity and innovation is already there because that will make you different from others, right? So this is all you can add. Read the story of Sushma, a toy maker, once again, and fill in the boxes mentioning the various qualities that Sushma might have possessed as an entrepreneur. First of all, she was patient, did not give up. Then she was very hardworking, making everything by her own. She was very having perseverance. She was very confident. She was taking risk also. So all these qualities Sushma possessed. That is how she created the website, started selling not only in India but to the world, the toys, wooden toys. So this is what you have to answer. She was very patient, did not give up. She waited until she achieved the success, right? She didn't leave the job she was up to. And she tried to understand the buying pattern of parents, because when her work was not going well, she actually tried to understand. She created a website. She took a risk because she inputted some money. So huge efforts, you know, because she was confident, she was showing that I have a good quality of work. Okay, this is all about this discussion. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.